Hello all, welcome to this video where we will learn about how to edit the videos and how to combine or join various videos along with the images. Now, in the last webinar series, we learned about Render Forest, where we can create animated videos, but the limit for the free version is only for a minute. So if I want to have a video for say like 10 or 15 minutes, then what we can do is, we can use the video editor tool and we can combine all those small 1 minute videos and we can make a big video irrespective of what is the limit allowed to us. Similarly, if we are recording any session and we think that there is some mistake in between, we want to cut that part and insert some another video, then what we can do is, we can again use the video editor. There are various video editing tools, but the one that is very simple and easy to use is the OpenShot. So type on your browser OpenShot, and this is the link that we have. Don't go for this Filmora one. Go to the second link, which is openshot.org. Click on this and click on this download. This is the latest version. So click on this download. I have already downloaded it. So I'll go to my desktop and I'll show you how the icon would appear. So this is the icon that would appear once you have downloaded the OpenShot video editor. Just click on this and the OpenShot video editor default screen would open. This is the OpenShot video editor. You can see there are few things. This middle one is the video preview where your video before or after editing would be visible to you. This is basically where all your audios, videos and images are kept. It is like a library from where you can then pick up the images and the videos or the audios and you can mix your all these things to make a proper video. These are the tracks where you can mix the videos, audios and the images, and these are the various settings available. Let us first see this file. Here in this file, you can see there are various options. You can make a new project. You can open the projects that have already been made. You can save the project. Any project that you have made using the OpenShot can be saved also. You can import the files and you can also. Now, to start mixing these things, what we have to do is, there are two options to import the files, the video or the images. The first is, you can simply go to any of the video, like this is the video. You can drag and drop it over here. Right? Similarly, if you want to bring any image, you can simply drag it and bring it over here. So this is the first option. The second option is, go to file. Go to import files and here you can browse wherever your videos or images are there. You can simply browse them and you can bring them over here. Right. So this is how it can be done. Now this is there in the library. It is not in the workable format. So what we have to do is whatever image or video you want to insert in your final video that has to be brought to these tracks. Okay, these tracks are important. Whatever is placed in these tracks, that is only going to be exported. So first, let me bring this image out here. So this is the image that I have. Now, let me bring this video. Now, one thing is very important. If I start playing this, now what happens is this image is for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, the video will start. The image, that is, you want that for the 15 seconds, the image should be there and then there should be a transition to the video. Then simply click on the video, right? This is the video. Just simply click on this. It has become red. Red means that now this is the activated thing and you can drag it back. Now go to image, click it. Now this has become red. It means that we can now work on this. So you can simply extend it and up to your choice. So it is like for 30 seconds. After that, the video would start playing. if you want that there should be a transition from image to video, then what you can do is you can overlap. So just click on this video, it has become red, and drag it over the image. So you can see this is the blue portion. This blue portion would be showing you the transition where both the image as well as the video would be playing. Let us see how. Video. So this is the transition space which can be increased or decreased. You can increase or decrease the transition space also. Now, if you don't want this transition, you can simply click on this transition. It has become red and click on the delete button on your keypad. So what will now happen? There is no transition and you can drag the video back. So there would be clear image and then there would be a clear video. Now let us move to the second part. Go to the effects, and here we have various effects that you can introduce in your image. What I'll do is I'll simply select any effect and drag it over the image. So you can see how this image has now been converted into this negative, right? If you want to remove this effect, what you have to do is you can see this N written over here. This N stands for the effect that I have brought in. Just right click on this and go to remove effect. So your normal image is here. I can also use any other effect, right? If you want it, it's fine. If you don't want it, you can right click and remove the effect. So this is how the effect would be there. Transitions. If you want that the transition from the image to the video should be in this kind of a thing like circle out to in, so we can also drag this over here from the image to the video and let us see how the transition would look like. See, so it has circle out to end. It would be there. So you can go for the transitions, the effects and the project files. Now I'm deleting this transition, and one very important thing that we generally use is to cut our video. So for that, what we have to do is we'll just play the video and we'll see where we want to cut this video.
We click on the bar.
And suppose I want to cut it over here. So I'll go to this razor tool. I'll activate this, and wherever you want to cut it, you can simply click the mouse and you can see that the video has been cut into this part. And once the video has been cut, go back to the razor tool and deselect it. Now there is no razor here. And what I can do is, if you want to remove this part, you can remove it. If you want to drag it back, you want to put it at the end, that too can be done. You can simply drag it to the end of your video. Right? So this is how it can be done. Now one very important thing is, or you can also delete this, just click on this, it should be red, and press the delete button on your keyboard. And one more thing is, you should always note that this particular magnet kind of a thing should be always activated so that the images are joined together. They are automatically attracted to each other and there is no empty space in between. Now once we are through with the video, what we have to do is we have to export this project. How we'll export this? Again, there are two options. You can click on this red button, export the video, and you can give it a name. You can browse the folder where you want to save this. You can also change the file format in the format that you want to save. You can also change the resolution and the quality, and then you have to click on export video. When you'll export video and it has been done 100%, your video will be saved in this particular folder, from where then you can upload it to the drive or on the YouTube and share with your students. The other option to export the video is to go to file, go to export project, and go to export video. You would be redirected to the same box. From here also you need to export the video to any particular folder. I hope you would be actually using this software to edit your videos to the perfection so that it can be delivered to your students for their future reference. Thank you.